Oh, I feel better. This is going to be a confusing speech in that I'm over here and my slides are over there. I don't have control of my slides. You know? I'd like that if Ken, if you could help me and make the changes for me on the slides. And I'd also like if you guys could look at the slides, because otherwise, why did I spend so much time with all that white space? Right now, I'm beginning to think I should have picked a more dynamic topic. But my topic today is going to be on, well, wait for it. Let's talk about the slide first. Take a look at that. Do you ever find yourself, you try to go to bed, you're listening to the news, you're thinking about Ebola, ISIS, ISIL, the economy, your job, your kids, your family, and you can't fall asleep. So you reach for ZQL, Tylenol PM, start counting the sheep. You look like that little baby over there. Do you know that over-the-counter sleeping aid tablets in the U.S. are, in 2013, are $310 million? That is a lot of sleep aids. But let me tell you, I have got a better solution. Punctuation! We've got commas, we've got parentheses, we've got periods, we got quotation marks, we have everything in there. Now, how did I get on punctuation and sleeping? It was by accident. My kids have this book at home. As a matter of fact, it was a middle school reading book. And after now reading it, I understand why they did not read it. Every time I started reading that book, I fell asleep. It is one of the hardest books to read, in my opinion. Who wants to talk about periods and question marks and colons and, well, not that kind of colon. semicolons. Hold on 1 second. Yes, thank you. And so there it is. There's our exclamation point. There's our parentheses. There's our comma, our period. And you might be thinking, well, what about all this stuff? Well, the history of it is actually kind of interesting. The reason that punctuation actually started was because when people would be speaking, they needed to know where to take a breath. And as a matter of fact, the Catholic priests, many of them, did not speak Latin. And so they had no idea what they were saying. And so they needed to find a place to pause so that their sentences made sense. So they would put spaces in there to say, okay, this is where you should stop, take a breath, burp, and continue on. And then what happened? The printers are the ones who actually helped us with punctuation. As a matter of fact, Aldus Manutius began printing punctuation in the late 1400s and the early 1500s. And he was the one who invented the italic typeface, and he was the first one to use a semicolon. Hold on 1 second. Yes. And then his grandson, who had the exact same name, so they had referred to him as Aldus Manutius the Elder and Aldus Manutius the Junior. Thank you. It was something else, though, they called him. But anyway, that's close enough. And so he was the one who was credited with starting to print commas, periods, and colons. So let's look at the comma, because that's a good one to start with. Now you might think that the comma is just a comma. Let's look at the definition of the comma. To illuminate the grammar of a sentence, to point up, rather in the manner of a musical notation, such as literary qualities as rhythm, direction, pitch, tone, and flow. Boring. Oh, my book down and I'm going to sleep, because who cares about that definition? However, let's look at this sentence. Let's eat Toastmasters. Well, really, is that what we want to do? No, the purpose of punctuation is to be clear. Now look at this sentence. Let's eat Toastmasters. A whole different sentence, because we added that itty bitty comma. Let's put up another sentence. He shot himself as a child. Is that what we really want to say? No, he shot himself as a child. You take out himself, he shot as a child. Now you know that he didn't shoot himself, but he shot as a child. Commas help us be clear on what we are trying to say. One of the reasons I read this book is because I'm trying to be a better speaker, so I thought if I was a better writer, I'd be a better speaker. I know people who want to be better writers take up speaking because they want to be better writers, but I'm doing it in reverse. Commas are for lists. You use them before direct speech, and they come in pairs. But that's enough about commas. Commas are on the bottom. Apostrophes are on the top. So you got to be really tall if you want to be an apostrophe. What is the purpose of an apostrophe? Apostrophe gives you possessiveness. The boy's dog had a toy. Whose dog? The boy's dog. However, here is a major mistake that people make with the word its, because a lot of people use the apostrophe on its. Its toy was red, round, and plush. But there are many possessive nouns. Mine, ours, yours, yours, his, theirs, hers, theirs, its, theirs. Its toy is missing. It's already possessive. But if you're using that apostrophe, the only time that you would use an apostrophe is in its, is if it's it is or it has. So an easy tool to use in your mind is if you can read your sentence, it is your turn, you use apostrophe in its. If you read your sentence, it has got very cold, you use your apostrophe in its. A lot of this information I got is from this book, Eat, Shoots, and Leaves. But I want to leave you with a final thought on how powerful punctuation can be. Take a look at these last two sentences. A woman without her man is nothing. Versus a woman without her man is nothing. Thank you.